Facebook has been fined £500,000 in the UK over the Cambridge Analytica scandal. Officials there say Facebook failed to ensure the data firm properly deleted users' information while doing work for right-wing political causes. For more, senior producer at CNET, Dan Patterson, joins us now. Great to see you.
Great to see you.
Let's first talk about this fine. For a company as big as Facebook, this is a drop in the bucket. Is this more of a warning?
Yeah, I'm shocked. It's so much money. This is just over $600,000 U.S. For Facebook, this is probably their spare cash.
Right.
It's not so much about the dollar amount as it is the imposition of a fine and regulator saying, hey, look, this type of behavior is really not okay with us.
And it is the max fine for
Correct.
The UK. So does this then indicate that a US fine may follow?
Well, with the Trump administration, really, when it comes to regulation, almost anything is possible. Mm-hmm. And I don't think we should look at something on a federal level. What we should look at are New York State and California. We could see GDPR-like regulations in the state of California, although that becomes a little tenuous because California is also the home base of not just Facebook, but Silicon Valley. So every other big tech enterprise. And of course, that means revenue for the state. So we see privacy regulations coming into place in California, but we don't know how tough they will be on companies like Facebook.
Now, we know that Wired recently reported that in 2015, I believe, Facebook gave a Russian company access to users' data. What do we know about this, and has this problem been fixed?
Yeah, so this was mail.ru, and this was Yuri Melner, a part investor in Facebook. So it doesn't look like this is a smoking gun, and I have a few different reactions to this. One is my journalistic reaction, and that is, look, there is no evidence. This was treated like all of the other apps on Facebook where they may have had additional access to user data. Facebook says, well, you know, there was a sunset period and some of these apps just had a little longer access. I also have a personal reaction to this, and that is there are just too many connected dots that say Russia all over them. And it is shocking to me that a company that is working on artificial general intelligence trying to make robots that are as smart as humans telling us that we just can't track the IP addresses of those who purchase ads, and it's impossible for us to track this down. There is an opacity here that none of us can penetrate.
But so it's kind of terrifying.
It's terrifying that a company would look the other way until after the fact. And whether we know the actual facts, and this may remain opaque for a long time, what we do know is that Facebook has repeatedly given away access, very sensitive access to data. This isn't just your news feed, but this is the metadata on your phone calls. They were tracking your text messages, who you would text, who you would call. For many of us, those are sensitive contacts. So it is a company that misbehaved time and time again and now says, oh golly, Sorry,
we didn't get it right. And despite all of this scandal and all of this controversy, it does not seem to be hurting Facebook or Mark Zuckerberg's bottom line. On Friday, he was named the third richest human on Earth. So does that mean that none of this really, at the end of the day, matters to users? The scandal doesn't matter. Facebook will just hum along totally uninterrupted and not take a hit over any of this?
Well, Facebook has differentiated themselves pretty well. You know, of course, they own WhatsApp, they own Instagram, they own Oculus Rift, and of course, they own the Facebook platform. Everyone I talk to who has adolescent children says, well, Facebook's no longer cool, but Instagram is the new hot thing.
Right.
However, Facebook engages in what we call in technology coercive design. Coercive design is design that pushes the users back to Facebook or Facebook properties by using psychological tricks. So Facebook's bottom line, probably just fine.
Absolutely. Dan Patterson, thank you so much.
Great to see you.
Great to see you as well.